Hello everybody and welcome to I Want a Mini Bike. And as you can see, it is day one. Yes, and we're still up on the archway. I literally just picked up right where the last episode left off. I rebooted my computer and it did exactly what I thought it would do. I was crouching. Okay, I was very, very confused there for a moment. But it did exactly what I thought it would do, and it reset the day. I really wish it wouldn't reset the day, but I would assume that the guys, the fun pimp guys, are doing, you know, more important things than fixing this little glitch. Oh, it's a bunny. I thought it was a rock. I'm like, wait, this rock looks weird. It's a bunny. Anyways, I rebooted my computer because I was fiddling with hardware and software and all kinds of crazy shit. I don't have my bow, so I'm just gonna run along. Run along home. I'd make a joke, but I don't remember what that phrase was in DS9 anymore. That was DS9, right? Yeah, that was the one with the game, and they said something special, and it was move along home. And stuff like that. I forget the actual phrase anymore. But anyways, let's see. What did I do to my PC? Well, first things first, I reset all of the video settings for Shadowplay to actually record at 1440. See, before it was set to record at screen resolution. Now, the screen resolution changed depending on what game I was playing or however I had it set. But for the most part, I try to keep it at 1440. For some reason, when it recorded and outputted at current display setting, it outputted at 1080. No idea why. But in theory, it should be outputting the video at 1440 now instead of 1080. Because I actually have it physically set to 1080. I put in two new hard drives. So I went out to Best Buy, picked up a couple of pairs, I picked up a pair of 1 terabyte hard drives and put them in as a RAID 0, so a stripe. So both hard drives are running as one, and it's running data across both hard drives, not quite doubling my access speed. It's complicated how that works, but there's a little overhead for the RAID. But it is writing to both hard drives simultaneously, and it will read from both hard drives simultaneously. So in theory, it should, it would double my access time. So my read-write times, it would double them. Now, of course, it ain't going to, because that's not how hard drives work. That's not how RAID work, but it does increase my performance considerably, noticeably. So, in theory, I can actually read to and write from this drive faster. So I can record at higher resolutions. I was thinking about getting a solid-state drive, but they are bloody expensive. And I figured my motherboard does RAID. May as well do it this way. A lot of zombies out today. So I can, yeah. So, yeah. Yes, so I can get the increased performance as well as increased hard drive space. Because, I mean, a 500 gig solid-state hard drive at Best Buy was $150. Both these hard drives combined to make the 2 terabyte was $120. Still not the best deal I could have, and they are, they're Seagates, but they're not, like, performance Seagates. They are, however, they're on the level of Western Digital Blue, so all around good performance, good reliability, that kind of thing. Not RAID class like the Western Digital Reds, but, you know, you work with what you work with. You work with what you got. So hopefully this is all turning out better than it did before, because I found out a big problem. You guys will have to let me know if this has happened in the previous videos. In the last video I recorded that just went live yesterday, I found out that the audio was recording at a different speed than the video. Are you coming at me? No, I'm not hunted. So, like, it was recording... Was it recording faster? Was it recording... It had to have been recording slower. But the output was offset. So at the beginning it was set, at the end it was offset, and it sucked. Let's throw them in there, because I'll need gasoline for the minibike. Boop. And here I go, I lost my train of thought. Anyway, so I spent a considerable while, realigning the audio beginning to end for that video file. And it turned out pretty good, but the audio sync is weird. I mean, it's not broken anymore, but it's still a little weird. But you have to really know what you're looking for to tell. So hopefully that turned out okay. I guess you guys will let me know. But also let me know if that had happened before, if the audio sync was off before and I just never noticed. And it's very distinctly possible that I never noticed because I was trying to rush through a lot of the video editing before then and kind of ended up not fully watching the videos like I really should have. And I didn't do the rock trick that I was going to do, did I? Whatever. Grab all my stuff. Though a lot of this is going to change, because I'm finally going to do the thing that I wanted to do now that I have all this cotton. Oh, and I didn't use my beer either. Well, I guess that turns out to be a good thing. That's my good reinforced club. Wooden bow. Tools. Flashlight. I don't have any food on me. Put those away. Yes, so hopefully the recording is turning out better than it was before. That goes somewhere else. I guess I'll find out. I'll find out before you guys will, because, you know, I'll edit the damn thing. So, yeah, fun times. But I'm also hoping that I'll be able to record at higher resolutions, maybe even 4K. I don't know why. It's not really needed, especially for this game. I mean, it looks pretty as fuck, but it doesn't look any better at 1440 than it did at 1080. It probably will later on, but not yet. All right, so what do I want to do? I want to do the cotton thing, and I want to make myself some armor, finally. So let's... Oh, wait, hang on. Crafting. Split. Craft that, and while that's going on, I'm going to... look into what sound I just heard. It sounded like a spider zombie. Oh, there's a bear over there. That's definitely not the sound I heard. But I swear I heard a spider zombie. Is that guy over there? But I haven't seen a spider zombie in a very, very long time. Like, I don't see them. I mean, I know they exist. I've seen them in other people's Let's Plays. But I've never actually... I haven't seen one in mine for an extremely long time. Alright, so we have cloth fragments. So let's see what kind of armor. Chest. Iron chest armor I could make, which I do have the tools for. So let's see. Iron. Iron bars, chest armor, leg armor. Can I do space armor? No. How about just armor? Okay, so this will give me all of my armor. Iron leg armor, iron chest armor. So let's make that. So let's grab this. I'm going to need a lot of these bastards, aren't I? Actually, let's do some math. So iron chest armor needs 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then iron leg armor needs 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 15. All right, so I need 4 of these, which will make 16. Whatever the crap these... forge iron. So that'll work. I need some leather, which I have. Or I have animal hide. Hopefully I can make leather. And then I'll make cloth everything else because I don't have anything else armor-wise to make. Oh, but armor is the wrong word, isn't it? Ooh, let's try boots. I have leather boots, so I can make leather boots. Okay, cool. Oh, but I can't make... crap. So, if I want to make leather boots, I need leather. But I can't make leather. Shit. Crap, so I can't make iron fucking anything. Let's put that stuff there for right now, because that's going to end up being my armor eventually. So, I guess I need to make cloth stuff. Oy. Well, that's actually quite annoying. I know how to make leather boots. I know how to make leather strips, but I don't know how to make leather. Okay. This is strange to me. It's very, very strange to me. I don't know. But there was that Born and Noble in that village we found. We should head there. Not the one where the flag is right now. But the other one. This doesn't give me that much armor, so I'm going to avoid that. Don't know if cloth boots give me that much armor. So I'm going to avoid that too, because I have boots and I have the football helmet. And the football helmet gives me more armor. So I'm going to go with that right now. Leg armor, chest armor, gloves. And I think that's it. I need a coat. I could use a bandana. But that covers my armor. Let's see. Worn boots. Bullet protection, 7%. Repair item, cloth fragment. Alrighty. I love how everything provides protection. Actual protection of one form or another. Let's see. Leg armor has bullet protection of 7. So yeah, chances are cloth boots won't provide that much protection. I love how my purple tank top provides 14% bullet protection. That's hella bullet protection. That's amazing. That's crazy. Alright, so let's see. Where was that village? The village was this way, wasn't it? Yeah, right here. That was where I was going, wasn't it? Or that's where I was earlier. I don't know. Let's go there. Hi, bear. What time is it? It is 1300 hours. Ooh, it's actually pretty late already. But I don't want to... Should I try to go? Because it's 1300 hours. It's relatively late in the day. And that's pretty far away. How far away is my waypoint? 0.8 kilometers. I should be able to do that. I could do that in real life. Make less than a kilometer and not very long. Because a kilometer is what? A little over a third of a mile? And, you know, like people walk at what, 2 to 4 miles per hour? And I'm kind of jogging at the moment, so we should be able to get there pretty damn quick. However, time is accelerated, but distance isn't shrunk. Yeah, because a meter is actually a meter in this game. So, fun. Confusing level stuff. But I guess it works. Makes sense. I mean, it wouldn't make sense to shrink distance. Whereas it does make sense to shrink time. Ooh, we're talking about relativity here, aren't we? Shrinking time but not shrinking distance? my brain just went to all of those sci-fi books I've ever read about travel close to the speed of light. Like the Doom books. The original Doom books. I forget who's the author of them. But yeah, the I think they're the official Doom books too. So there's like Knee Deep in the Dead, Hell on Earth, I forget what the third book's called, and Endgame. I'm trying to find the third book again. I have all four of them. I want to read them again. I read Knee Deep in the Dead, I read Hell on Earth, but I can't find my third and fourth copy, my copy of third and fourth. But the third book is where everything just starts going off the wall. Now, the first and second books, they insist that the demons that are coming in and trying to kill everybody are aliens. But in the third and fourth book, they prove that the demons that are coming in are actually aliens. And it just really goes off the wall, and it's kind of disappointing. But one of the things that's in there is that in that universe, there is no such thing as FTL travel. Wow, you just came right up to me, didn't you? Okay, he just died. See, I stopped because I figured that there was a giant cliff here. It just felt right. Oh, and I very surely almost broke my ankle. Oh, he didn't die. Hang on, I want food. Yeah, I didn't think I was going to succeed at this. Yeah, all right. Moving along. All right, let's see what's in the Born and Noble. It's 1,450 hours. That's lots of time, actually. Hell of a lot more time than we had before. Wait, is this the right village? No, I think this is the wrong village. But it's an identical copy of the previous, or the village that I'm thinking of. Except, of course, there's a bear right there. Am I hitting this guy at all? Because he's not reacting. There he goes. Yeah, this may not be a wise idea. Aside from the fact that there's a bear there fighting zombies. We'll let him fight zombies as long as he doesn't bother me. Though, there's an interesting thing with this game that I've noticed. Is that even if the bears are aggro to zombies, like actively aggro to zombies, like right now, if I get close enough, it will attack me. It will stop attacking the zombie and it will attack me. At least that's what I found. So I'm going to stay away, let it... If I can ever kill this bloody nurse zombie... Come on, right? Damn it! Thank you! Ooh, and I'm level 12 now. No, that doesn't get me any higher equipment. But, so many bloody zombies. Love the bow positioning change. Dude, they really need to fix this glitch. Because it's kind of impossible to see where I'm aiming with the bow. As it stands, anyways. Especially when it does that. It's like, all of a sudden, I can't see where the hell I'm aiming. This game is hard enough without glitches. Alright, so here I am. The bear is outside and doesn't care about me. No, this is the... what I witnessed before. Or where I went before. And I hear zombies out there. Am I... No, I'm undetected. I'm sensed. Alright, that's going to be a problem later. Yeah, because there's a zombie right there. Oh, I picked up a leather something or other. Because I can't fucking see. I'd pull out the flashlight, but... I've got the zombie problem. And my bow is pretty well fucked at the moment. So, running, 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 running. Axe. Let me axe you a question. I know, it's a stupid joke, old joke. Terrible joke. However, it is a Futurama question, reference, so it makes things slightly better. Come on. Bow. Sticks. 1600 hours. Bow. Sticks. Maybe I should make a new bow see if I can get a higher level bow. Where'd the bear go? Oh, he's over there. Hi, lady. Bye, lady. All right, now the zombies aren't a problem. Oh, that guy is. I wonder if he busted his way in here. All right, now I can actually see what the hell I'm doing. And I won't pick up random couch cushions. Yeah, I should be picking up the books, just the regular books, not the learning stuff. These guys, just the books. Because you can turn them into paper, and paper is used to make blunderbuss ammo, and I should probably just make a blunderbuss and be done with it. Fucking bears. Whee! Bullet schematic, that's useful, because I think I can take those bullets apart. I have those bullets, I think. Thus, I can take them apart, make bullet tip molds, then I can make more bullets. Ooh, shotgun shells. Leather tanning! There it is! There it is! Now I can make iron armor. Sweet. Ooh, and a leather hat. And a sledgehammer. Not 100% sure what sledgehammers do. Are they weapons? Do they repair? No, I think they are just weapons. But last time I actually played with a sledgehammer, it didn't work. Ooh, sniper. I want a sniper rifle. I do want a sniper rifle, but I can never get the parts for it. I have leather tanning already. I just haven't read it yet. 1719. I should probably bail here very soon. Glass jar. Just make glass jars, really. So much to search. Cat food? Dog food? I was gonna say, do I find people food? No. That's locked, so let's quickly get in here. What do we got? What do we got? What do we got? Oh, auger schematic, iron gloves. Ooh, we are making a killing. We just have to get the hell out of here. Something good, something good, something good. Nothing good. Nothing. Not just nothing good, just nothing. I'm a-coming. Here's Johnny. This takes forever. I mean, I know it's realistic, but it still takes for freaking ever. Oh, and there's a safe inside, and that takes forever. Boop. Leather glove schematic. I mean, I ain't gonna make leather gloves because, ooh, black bandana. There, now I have the bandana. Let's start learning some of these things. Actually, I should probably go home and learn them. 1800 hours. I have 4 hours in game. Let's see if I can crack this safe open. Expert safe cracker here. High level, elite skills. Detected, good. Oh god, this takes forever. I have a low-end pickaxe, that's the problem. Very low-end pickaxe, it's a faulty pickaxe. 1800 hours. If 1900 hours comes along and I'm not into this thing yet, I'm gonna bail. Because I gotta get back before night. And that's obviously kind of an important thing. I'm not even noticing, like, any details letting me know that I'm actually getting anywhere with this bloody thing. I don't think the pickaxe is gonna last till 1900 hours. Nothing. Still. Holy crap. There it goes. Finally. Wrench schematic, that's useful, kind of ish. Alright, let's bail. Alright, I cleared this place out pretty good. Actually, not quite. Hang on. Flashlight. Alright. There. Yeah, so, let's grab little bit more. Oop, that was water. That might be useful later. Nope. All right, now let's bail. Get the crap on out of here. Whee! All right, home, home. All right, so we had a good day. We had a very good day. Probably should have looked around before I started searching this thing. Raw pork, pig fat, animal hide. Yes, let's go. All right, big honking zombie right there. So let's just avoid him. Ooh, another pig, another pig, another pig. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Oh, it's probably getting eaten by that damn plant. There we go. Because with this, I can make bacon and eggs. And with bacon and eggs, I can carry around food without getting detected by zombies. Oh, that fat pig. He had 6 pieces of pork. We are having a good day today. This was a good day. Now let's see if I can actually get home before night, before the zombies come out and say hello. Because you know me, I'm absolutely terrified. Oh, I thought it's a rock. I thought it was a deer. Like that would be like the icing on the cake in this game, or for today. It's like it venison as well. That would be sweet. Shouldn't be that long. There's a bear. Well, there is that bear at home. I could try to kill it. Get some more bear meat. Bear meat does absolutely amazing when it comes to hunger. Drink something real quick. Whee! Gets my stamina back. Let's go. Ooh. 1945. Still got plenty of time. Lots of time. Lots of time. Whee! So, I guess I should start planning on what to do for tomorrow. In-game, obviously. Let's think. What do I want to do? Well, why don't you guys... Well, I would say why don't you guys give some suggestions, but I'm probably going to be recording tomorrow's episode before this one goes live. I might. I don't know. I never really know how my timing works. But I'm open to suggestions on just about anything. What do you guys suggest? We still got to do a lot of searching. Now that I got, like, iron armor and stuff like that, and I'm starting to level up, we're going to be focusing more on exploring the area, digging through villages, that kind of thing, and seeing if we can find all of the parts and the, schematics necessary to, build a minibike, because that's the entire point of the show, is building that damn minibike. Are we home yet? I can't tell. Yes, we are home. Hopefully there aren't too many zombies around. Though there is that guy. Yeah, I'm dragging zombies along with me because I have pig meat in my backpack. Though I think it only increases my detection by like 5 blocks or something like that. Not a lot. Not a lot at all. Alright, so let's chuck you real quick into there. Raw pork 10. Bag smell range 20. Damn. Okay, so that increases it by 20 meters if it's in my bag. That's this area here. And 60 meters if it's in my belt. Wait. Oh. Belt smell range 60 meters. Belt smell strength 4 meters. Whatever the shit that means. Alright, anyways. Eggs. Pork. Do I have the right thing in here? Yes, I do. So, pork, eggs, minute 40 cook time. So I need some wood real quick. One of these will get me 3 minutes. Yep, cook. All right, so now I have bacon cooking. Bacon. Let's start looking at some of these things. Gotta cook me some, I lost my train of thought. Have to cook me some water here soon. Yeah. I wonder, do I have the med kit blueprint? Gotta make an auger. I want to make an auger. Do I have an auger blade in this world? I don't think I found an auger blade in this world, did I? A little disappointing, but whatever. What's that flashing? Up here. Do you guys see that? I wonder if that shows up in the video. I've been having some interesting graphical issues. Oh, it is. Okay, because that's the fire flashing. Okay. I've been having some very interesting graphical issues recently. I think it's because I have the Oculus Rift plugged in, but I haven't bothered to install it yet. It is new that I actually have the Oculus Rift plugged in. But I think that's the problem. The first aid kit. Yeah, I wonder if I can make first aid kits yet. Let's see. Leather couch middle. Nope, cannot. I was gonna say, can I tear that apart? Nope. That goes there. That goes there. That goes there. But I can actually make leather now. Yeah, we'll throw that there for right now. So let's make some leather, and I can make my armor stuff. Do I use animal hide for anything else? I don't think so. That's going to take several minutes. 2150, it's almost 2200 hours. I have bacon and eggs, lots of them. Whee! Alright, now, million dollar question. Where, oh where, oh where is my, there it is, cooking pot. So, put the cooking pot here. I should probably hide. It tends to get bad. Water, water, water. Let's just, nah. I was gonna say, let's crouch, but nah. I'm gonna be drawing a lot of zombies, aren't I? Oh, wait. No, I need this. Come on. There we go. And then seven more. That gives me all the murky water, and I don't have any murky water in here. No, I just have regular bottled water. So let's boop, boop, and a boop. Alright, so let's get me some wood so I can cook that up. And then tomorrow, because that's going to take fucking 12 minutes. Alright, so then tomorrow, I will cook up the goldenrod. So, as we say goodnight and fare thee well and all the fun crap that I can't think of interesting stuff off the top of my head, I will say to you guys, as always, keep playing the game. And have fun.